when we stand. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And of your spirit.
My beloved brothers and sisters, Reverend Father Mike, we are gathering this evening to celebrate Memorial Mass for our brothers and sisters who have come before us, praying for God's mercy, and the Lord will grant them eternal rest and peace.
Tonight we are here to honor our brothers and sisters who have died in Christ. In scriptures, God shows us the glory of heaven and how to live our lives on earth to enter that glory. In the Gospels, Christ tells us that living a Christian life is more than prayer. It is good works informed by faith. Edward Olezo Jr. Edward Olezo Jr. Edward Olezo Jr.
Absent.
Brother Edward took his first degree April 1st, 1961. He died March 22nd, 2020. He was a member for 58 years. When I was hungry, you gave me food. Jesus Bohorquez, Jesus Bohorquez, Jesus Bohorquez.
Absent.
Brother Jesus took his first degree April 1st, 1956. He died March 11th, 2020. He was a member for 63 years. When I was thirsty, you gave me drink. Auricio Briones, Auricio Briones, Auricio Briones.
Absent.
Brother Auricio took his first degree June 1st, 1991. He died January 2nd, 2020. He was a member for 28 years. When I was naked, you clothed me. Past Grand Knight, Jim DeGeeter. Past Grand Knight, Jim DeGeeter. Past Grand Knight, Jim DeGeeter.
Absent.
Brother Jim took his first degree May 1st, 1959. He died June 14th, 2020. He was a member for 61 years. When I was a stranger, you welcomed me. Gregory Dumas. Gregory Dumas. Gregory Dumas.
Absent.
Brother Gregory took his first degree December 23rd, 1949. He died October 28th, 2019. He was a member for 70 years. When I was ill, you cared for me. Richard Divas. Richard Divas. Richard Divas.
Absent.
Brother Richard took his first degree September 1st, 1969. He died April 26th, 2020. He was a member for 50 years. When I was naked, you clothed me. Frank Grosso, Frank Grosso, Frank Grosso.
Absent.
Brother Frank took his first degree September 1st, 1966. He died May 6th, 2014. He was a member for 47 years. When I was in prison, you visited me. Past Grand Knight, Bob Lombardo. Past Grand Knight, Bob Lombardo. Past Grand Knight, Bob Lombardo.
Absent.
Brother Bob took his first degree March 12th, 2002. He died October 25th, 2020. He was a member for 18 years. If anyone wishes to be first, he shall be servant to all. Past Grand Knight, Bernard Montag. Past Grand Knight, Bernard Montag. Past Grand Knight, Bernard Montag.
Absent.
Brother Bernard took his first degree October 1st, 1957. He died November 12th, 2020. He was a member for 62 years. James Mooney. James Mooney. James Mooney.
Absent.
Brother James took his first degree July 1st, 1954. He died June 10th, 2020. He was a member for 65 years. Mark Smith. Mark Smith. Mark Smith.
Absent.
Brother Mark took his first degree on June 30th, 2015. He died on May 25th, 2020. He was a member for 4 years. Thomas Tate. Thomas Tate. Thomas Tate.
Absent.
Brother Thomas took his first degree on October 1st, 1963. He died on July 29th, 2020. He was a member for 56 years. Salvador Sadita. Salvador Sadita. Salvador Sadita.
Absent.
Brother Salvador was a member of Council 4956 and took his first degree March 1st, 1984. He died September 6th, 2017. He was a member for 36 years. Tonight, we are also honoring two Columbiettes who have passed away. Teresa Kaminsky. She died January 24th, 2020. Jean Spihar. Jean died December 8th, 2019. Our Blessed Mother sat beside the Lord at his feet, listening to him speak. There were also women looking on from a distance. These women had followed him when he was in Galilee and ministered to him. Our final rose is in honor of all the unborn who died this year. In this injustice lies our greatest work. Whatever you do for the least of my brothers, you do unto me. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon them. May they rest in peace.
Amen.
May their souls and the souls of the faithfully departed rest in peace.
Amen.
To prepare ourselves to celebrate the wonderful gift of the Holy Eucharist, let us acknowledge our sins.
I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, and I have highly sinned in my thoughts and my words and what I have done and what I have failed to do. To my thoughts, to my most gracious thoughts. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, glory of the faithful and life of the just, by the death and resurrection of whose Son we have been redeemed, look mercifully on your departed servants, that just as they profess the mystery of our resurrection, so they may merit to receive the joys of eternal happiness. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns within the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seem, in the view of the foolish, to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction. But they are in peace, for if in the eyes of men indeed they be punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. Chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them. And as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love. Because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial psalm, I will live in the house of the Lord forever.
I will live in the house of the Lord forever.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake.
I will live in the house of the Lord forever.
Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil, for thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they will comfort me.
I will live in the house of the Lord forever.
You prepared a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You have anointed my head with oil, my cup overflows.
I will live in the house of the Lord forever.
Surely goodness and kindness shall follow me all the days of my life. In the Lord's own house I shall dwell forever and ever.
I will live in the house of the Lord forever.
The second reading. A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. Beloved, I am already being poured out like a libation, and the time of my departure is at hand. I have completed well, I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. From now on, the crown of righteousness awaits me, which the Lord, the just judge, will award me on that day. And not only to me, but to all who have longed for his appearance. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. and of the Spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Martha said to Jesus, Lord, if you had been here, my brother never would have died. But even now, I know that whatever you ask of God, God will give you. Jesus said to Martha, your brother will rise. Martha said, I know he'll rise in the resurrection on the last day. Jesus told Martha, I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me, even if he dies, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this? Martha said, yes, Lord, I have come to believe that you are the Son of God, that you are the Christ, the Son of God, the one who is coming into the world. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
First, a word of congratulations to the Knights of Council 31, 48, and 49, 56, because it was on the vigil of All Saints Day that your founder, Father Michael McGivney, was declared blessed at St. Joseph's Cathedral in Hartford. You knew it for years, but now you've got the good housekeeping seal of approval on it. And so it is not as though when the church declares someone blessed, she's saying, oh, now, we're putting this one in heaven. God puts people in heaven. What she's doing is she's simply acknowledging, we know beyond the shadow of a doubt that this particular person is enjoying the presence of God Almighty and therefore can be commended to the faithful to intercede for them and in turn look to the faithful to look at that one and marvel and imitate their good deeds. And so it was a wonderful, wonderful time for the Knights of Columbus across the United States. But it is on that the vigil of that month of November that is so particular to us this evening. November is, in the Northern Hemisphere, is that great transition month. And so nature is making the change to going from the warmth and the light of summer to the cold and the dark, dare we say, the dead of winter. And so it's a month of transition. And during this month of transition, that's when the Church, our Mother, invites her children to now remember in a more particular way what she, as our mother, never ceases to forget. And that is her dead children. So every time she offers the Mass, every time Vespers evening prayer is sung or said, she always has a petition remembering her dead children and praying for her dead children. But it's during this month of transition that she calls all of her dead children to mind with a special intensity. And there it is that she now, figuratively speaking, gathers all of her deceased children into her arms and holds them up to God Almighty, and then sends her cries and her prayers for her dead children echoing and ricocheting across the corners of the entire universe, begging Almighty God to bring them into the Lord's kingdom of light and of happiness and of peace. So it's during this month that we remember all of our dead. To begin with, those that we have known in life and now lie in death, our grandparents, our parents, our aunts, our uncles, cousins, brothers, sisters, friends that we've had, those that we've known in life, we remember them and we commend them to the care of God Almighty. But there is another group of people that I always invite people to remember, and that's what we call the lost souls, the forgotten souls. Now, it's true, the Church as a mother never forgets any of her dead children, but it's rather, that comment is made for us, to remember how it is a good thing for us to remember and to pray for our dead brothers and sisters, even though we don't know them, we don't know where they are, where they live, their names, but we're all connected through the sacrament of baptism, and so it's good for us to, out of charity, to remember them and to pray for them and to offer them to God Almighty. This is a beautiful custom that you have, and it, in a sense, it is simultaneously haunting and heartrending to listen to those names that have now gone to the care of God Almighty since the last Memorial Mass of the Knights of Columbus. And at the same time, it is, to me, touching and most beautiful, and what emanates from a wonderful Catholic spirit. So I gotta go back and tell you a little story. I'm at my first assignment, so remember, I'm brand new. I was sent to a pastor whom I grew to love, and loved him until the day that the good Lord would choose to bring him from this life into eternal life. And the first 2.5 years there, there were two others in the house, so there were 4 of us all together. And so one of them was an older priest, an SVD, and he was from Johnstown, Pennsylvania. Now, as he would now say, and I'm hoping I don't shock any of you with your sensibilities, but he would describe himself, "I'm a bohunk." And remember, those Bohemians that had emigrated from the central part of Europe to come into the coal mines of Pennsylvania, they were tough, rugged people. And so was Father Stadady in so many, many ways. He was also lovable in so many ways. But after he was ordained, his community sent him to Rome to do post-ordination studies. So he wound up getting his degree in sacred theology in Rome, and so he lived in Rome for several years, and so this was his first encounter with the Italians. He'd only known the Bohunks before. He goes to Rome, gets to the Italians, and loved them. How can you not? Right. So he would come back, and his great observation was this. The Italians are great for many reasons, but there are 2 in particular, he says, that I find the most heartwarming. Number 1, they love their children. And number 2, they remember their dead. Well, I've thought of that and call it to mind every time, in my years in the priesthood. And I mentioned that any number of times, especially at funerals, because I think those 2 things, that you know, and it's not only the Italians, they don't have a monopoly on that. But I mention that simply to be faithful to the one who told it to me. But I think those 2 things help remind us of what is most profoundly human. Number 1, children are God's gift to this world of ours. And no matter in what manner, what shape, and what time, and what abilities a child might have from the moment of its conception, that child is a beautiful gift to this world of ours, and we love them because they're a gift from God. And number 2, we remember our dead. Why? Because we remember that at the end of the day, who we are and what we have in large measure is due to those that have gone before us. And so we stand, if you will, on the shoulders of our parents, on our grandparents, of our aunts and uncles. They have now helped us become what we are, and so we remember them. Whether they're living, great, beautiful, we can say thank you. If they have passed from this life into eternal life, then we simply commend them to the care of God Almighty. That's what you're doing on this beautiful, hushed evening, remembering those who were a part of your life by being joined to the Knights of Columbus. As Knights, Columbiettes, whatever it may be, we remember them, we call them to mind, and we commend them to the care of God Almighty, that the Lord welcome them into his kingdom of light, of happiness, and of peace.
I believe in one God,
Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, unconceived of the Father, him all offering for me. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from the holy filled with the Holy Spirit, you have conceived by the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the according to the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. And come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, Lord, the Liver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who the Father and the Son is Lord and glorified. He has spoken to the prophets. I believe one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead and life of the world to come. Amen.
My brothers and sisters, let us pray for the church and the leaders of the church, that God will bless Pope Francis and all the bishops and archbishops, cardinals, and those entrusted the power of leadership, that they will continue to lead God's people unto righteousness and holiness. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for the sick, for those who are suffering from coronavirus, that God will grant healing and strength to all his children, so that we all will recover and continue to honor him and praise him. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for members and families of Knight of Columbus, especially those who are grieving the loss of our beloved ones, and our members whom we are celebrating the demise today. Or that you bless their families, comfort them through the grace of the Holy Spirit. And to all who have gone before us, you grant them eternal rest. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace in our nation, for reconciliation and healing, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For forgiveness of our sins, for healing and recovery, for broken marriages, broken families, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For many priests who are suffering in different parts of the world, the missionaries, those who are being persecuted because of Christ, that you protect and guide them, save their lives, provide for their needs, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Eternal Lord, as we gather this evening to honor your name, we entrust our beloved brothers and sisters, whom you have called to rest unto your holy hand. Grant them the gift of resurrection through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Never grow, never grow, and never grow.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that the sacrifice of mine may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Almighty and merciful God, by means of these sacrificial offerings, wash away, we pray, in the blood of Christ, the sins of your departed servants. For you purify unceasingly by your merciful forgiveness those you once cleansed in the waters of baptism. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. For he is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, the resurrection of the dead. Through him, the host of angels adore your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, this gifts of prayer by sending down your Spirit upon the mighty dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, gave it thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray, that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, especially members of Knight of Columbus. who passed away this year. And all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, so we pray. That with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, let us now say our family prayer.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, and by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with your spirit.
Let us offer to one another a sign of peace.
Peace be with you, brother. Good to see you.
Peace be with you.
Peace be with you, brothers.
And you, my brother.
Thank you, my brother.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy to receive under your roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you. having received the sacrament of your only begotten Son, who was sacrificed for us and rose in glory, we humbly implore you, O Lord, for your departed servants, that cleansed by the Paschal mysteries, they may glory in the gifts of the resurrection to come, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with your spirit.
Almighty God bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in the peace of Christ. Our Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Yeah.